there's a YouTuber slash financial expert, I guess you could call him, named Caleb Hammer. I call him like the Dave Ramsey of Gen Z. And he has this YouTube show, and throughout his show, which I am genuinely obsessed with watching, he gives really blunt financial advice to young people in deep debt. And after watching these videos, again, almost obsessively in my free time, I started to notice a continual pattern in the guests that came onto the show in just ruinous debt. They all had a ton of student loans that they refused to pay.
I'm all out of money!
So I'm gonna show you guys some clips from the show and explain why I think Gen Zers aren't paying their student loans back. But before we get into watching this first video, would you please click the like and subscribe button? Make sure you're subscribed to this channel. Thank you, friend.
Your student loans. Are you paying minimum monthly payments on these?
I have never made a payment.
Are payments required currently?
I think they are. They started, I believe, last year. You see, I graduated in 2019. COVID happened right afterwards. So we didn't have to pay for 2 years. I was in deep.
You let them know you're in deep. You ask for deferral or you ask to be put on an income-based repayment. We don't just not pay them. They will garnish your wages. They will f*** you.
I love his faces. I love watching him just like also be equally mind blown. And I'm speechless when it comes to these videos most of the time. I mean, this is a perfect example. There was magic happening to repay her student loans. No, that's not how it works. Now, there is part of me that feels bad for people who are in student loan debt. Later on in this episode with this one woman, she explains how she got a degree in criminal justice, but she realized as she was crossing the stage at graduation that she didn't even like her degree. And yes, I know what you're thinking. I think we can chalk that up to poor life choices, but I think it's pivotal to the conversation about student loans and financial responsibility to call out the role that culture has played in forcing everyone into a 4-year college degree and lying to people saying that that will automatically bring you success. Gen Z and younger millennials were, generally speaking, sold a bag of goods when it came to going to college. We were promised, go to college, take out the loans, get the degree, get good paying jobs, and then you'll quickly be able to repay those student loans. But that was the traditional logic. And the truth is that we all went to college. We weren't told, though, that at this liberal arts college or 4-year state university we went to, that they were going to charge us out the butt, force us to pick a degree and build classes around that degree when we're 18 and stupid, and then we get out and good paying jobs don't exist anymore and they don't actually cover the cost of living anymore because inflation is
disgusting.
And also the middle class salary is like $120,000. So Gen Zers are working tons of hours, sometimes extra jobs, just to make the ends meet, and they aren't able to repay the student loans at the rate they thought they would. So they're just cloaked in more debt. But arguably the bigger problem in the financial ruin that we see going on with Gen Z is that the government keeps promising student loan forgiveness will just come and wipe away their debt. So they're waiting for this magical disappearing act to happen. And there's another Caleb Hammer clip that really showcases the insanity of student loan forgiveness happening to Gen Z.
$10,795 student loans, so it's your minimum payment, like $125. What?
I'm not paying it. I can be honest about that. Because they've been going down on their own. So I'm thinking the government got something to do.
He's crumpling the paper. Are
you sure you're not getting an automatic withdrawal?
Where would they pull it from?
Garnishing your wages before they hit your account. What? Why are you not paying this?
You see how they're saying 2% paid off, 1% paid off?
Yes, you've probably paid some money towards
it
at some point.
That's not me. That's what I'm saying. Somebody's doing some magic right now. Okay. I'm just going to let the magic keep happening.
You don't even know how worked up I am inside about this level of stupidity. I would like to note, though, that we all graduated in May of 2019. So unless she's a rare case and graduated in the winter of 2019, that means she still went 10 months without paying back her student loans. I'm so appreciative of Caleb, the guy conducting these interviews, because every time he reminds his guests of the reality that student loan forgiveness probably isn't going to happen. The Supreme Court already issued a ruling that the federal government could not just wipe away student loans. But despite that staunch reality, politicians keep promising young people they'll cancel student loans, and the result is actually devastating Gen Z. Gen Z is just hoping and praying that their student loan forgiveness will wipe away all their problems, but that's not reality. In fact, it's clearly a path to financial ruin. It frightens me for the future of my generation, but this should be a warning to politicians preaching about the issue. If you know that this isn't possible, stop giving people false hope. It's more than just politics. It's genuinely harming an entire generation of people. But as always, let me know what you think of these stories in the comments on your way out. Thanks so much for tuning in, and I'll see you here next time.